Thanks for joining us here on 2K Sports for NBA basketball. And tonight, we'll see the Cleveland Cavaliers as they go up against the Utah Jazz. With Richard Jefferson and Greg Anthony alongside, I'm Kevin Harlan at the table. And from the sidelines, it's our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. Hey, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. When I asked Coach J.B. Bickerstaff about Evan Mobley, he said his sole focus is, how do I help the Cleveland Cavaliers win basketball games? When you play the game with that purity of heart and then throw a skill set and intellect in, you've got a guy that impacts winning. He can do it so many different ways. Kevin?
He can. D.A., he's special. And thanks for your report. And checking out Utah's opening lineup, we've got Jared Vanderbilt. Clarkson is out there with Conley. Then it's Kelly Olynyk. And it's Markkanen in at the small forward. And for Cleveland, the defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Darius Garland is out there with Donovan Mitchell. And Stevens in at the three.
And you know there aren't many teams with a more dedicated fan base than Utah. The Jazz fans are behind their team no matter what.
And the Cavaliers start out with the ball. Olynyk with the steal. And he gets the button. Olynyk's got the first points up on the board for Utah.
And really, the improvement as a finisher is noticeable for Kelly Olynyk.
Well, wide open look here for Garland. All good with the triple. It's always striking, Greg, to see the bond between the Jazz team and their followers.
Well, when you're the only game in town, people take the team to heart. And we see it in cities like Portland and San Antonio as well. Fans form that attachment to their team. And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Olynyk with the steal. Fires the three. And Utah, another three.
They're finding every shot they've wanted so far. A perfect three of three to start the game.
Pass to Allen. First shot, first basket. He's on the ball stats.
Recognizing his teammates are open. Garland, great time right there.
And that outstanding drive and finish brought to you by Mobile One.
And no quit. Just keep playing the right way. Stay aggressive and try to battle back.
Now, here's Clarkson. And you know the points will always be there for him. He's averaging just a shade over 20 points a game right now. Let's it go with a three. Drains it from beyond the arc.
Yeah, this looks like a pregame shoot-around with all the threes they're allowed.
Hook loose. And Olynyk gets to Clarkson. It's good. Only a few seconds into the shot clock. Clarkson's got five now. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for Utah. Mitchell outside. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
One of the more powerful young guards in our game. Mitchell loves to attack the heart of the defense. And Garland, a finalist for most improved player of the year in 2022, took a huge leap forward with his play.
Garland, the pass to Stevens. The dish to Allen. And then Allen steers it in.
Allen! Size and strength in Allen's defensive foul.
And he put in the work, and it all came together for him, GM.
And his shooting reached a tipping point. He was given the keys as a playmaker, and this is a great situation for him. Boy, he's made the most of it.
Markkanen can't get it to go. Cavaliers have gone 3-4 from the field to start out the game. And that one, good.
Ideal way to start the game, come out of the gate, and knock down all but one of your first five shots.
Clarkson for three. The shot is good. And so is his shooting tonight. 3-for-4.
The defense is in disbelief here. Triple after triple.
So timeout called here. The first for Cleveland. They want to keep it rolling here following the win against Dallas.
And it was one of those games where it was just hard to get anything going. And you could see frustrations emerge.
What a gutsy win to struggle the offensive end that much and still in the game. That says something about the character of the team.
Here's the pass to Stevens.
And he shuts that one down. Nice pass right there from Garland.
far too many open rhythm looks.
Here's Garland. Michael Conley making his last shot. Back to Garland. To the middle. Here is Mobley. That's it. And it comes off an assist for Garland.
Darius Garland. Garland with the assist.
A smooth assist with that last one here tonight.
And there's one area where the Cavs have been very good the past few seasons. That's the draft. They made some terrific picks in terms of personnel.
Now, Garland. Following the miss by Michael Conley from deep. Here's Stevens. Excellent D there from Markkanen.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
Excellent D avoided fouling and got in perfect position to alter that shot.
You're right, GA, they have, and the draft's been essential for the rebuild effort in Cleveland.
And they've been so smart about it. You look at the guys they brought in, Mobley, Garland, Sexton. They nailed just about every one of their selections.
And we have to take another glance at that powerful rejection.
And right out of the gate, trying to set the tone defensively, you gotta love that energy.
Here's Garland. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Dallas.
And defensively, he's been all over the place.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this league.
A dunk like that is sure to give them a spark. The Cavaliers trail by 8 to the inside. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Clarkson kicks to Sexton. Off target from outside. And so it's Garland who brings up the ball for Cleveland. LeVert the pass to Osmond. That's tipped.
That's sixth man of the year hustle by Clarkson. Outworking the shooter and just locking him up. So you know what? Very close to a three-point play right there.
The Utahs shooting their first free throws of the night. Shooting free throw good. Sexton. Horton Tucker's checked in for the Jazz. And so he makes both from the line. We've got 22 seconds left here in the first quarter. A drive by Garland. Dunk by Garland.
Using that quick first step on his way to the rim, Garland is just too tough off the bounce.
Clarkson bounce pass. Sexton for three. And the three ball is good. Sexton's got 5 points so far.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Couldn't come up with a much better start than this. They just have to keep it going.
And so is Utah. Holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Richard, we're seeing a lot more back-to-backs now at this mid-portion of the season. What are those like to play in for a play?
They are fun because it's a mental challenge and it's a physical challenge more than anything on that one. But I love it. I am not opposed to back-to-backs because you know what? There are players that used to have to play them and fly on flights in the morning. Now we get to fly on private jets. So if they can do it, we can do it.
And you got to get your rest, though, between those games, don't you? Taking a look at the Jazz. Sexton is out there with Jordan Clarkson. Then it's Lauri Markkanen and Horton Tucker in at the small forward position.
They're taking it right into the teeth of the defense, and it's a defense that's starting to look frustrated.
That's the kind of aggression you want to see when you've got a team on the ropes.
Here's LeVert. They get the rebound. Come on. No good. They had a chance to end the run there.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. Caris LeVert has become one of the game's best slashers. He says, honestly, I just go to the front of the rim and work on different spins. Getting more comfortable with both hands and finishing. Kyrie Irving did that when he was younger, and that's one of the ways he became a great finisher. Kevin, back to you.
He is a great finisher. David, thanks. He's studying the greens, and it's paying off. Cavaliers with some changes. And the Mobley's jump in for Allen. Okoro comes in for Jetty Osman. And it's Mitchell in for Caris LeVert. Then for the Jazz, Vanderbilt's jumped in for Lauri Markkanen. And it's Beasley in for Talen Horton-Tucker.
And we've seen it for years. Despite the regular season success, the Jazz just unable to make much noise in the playoffs. Credit the front office for coming to terms with it and pivoting to a rebuild while they could get top value for their stars.
And that one's good, Mitchell's got his third basket of the night right there.
And with that basket right there, it brings an end to that 12-0 run by Utah.
Archon for three. It's the three-point bomb.
Talk about putting a team on your back. He has been dominant this quarter, and I don't think they are winning without him.
Driving to the basket.
Even when he first came into the league, this was Clarkson's go-to move, pressing the action off the boogie.
Cavaliers have gotten off to a rough start here in the second quarter, going just 1-for-5. Garland, the pass to Okoro. Floats one up. Vanderbilt with the rebound. Here's the Jazz with the ball. What a stretch they've got going here. 17-2. Shots good by Clarkson.
He's found his rhythm from deep, and you can see the confidence.
And, of course, it helps space the floor, which gives this offense more room to operate.
Garland, that's for two. Once again, off the mark by Cleveland.
And they've only got a slight edge on the boards, but it just feels a lot bigger.
Sexton for three. It's rebounded by Cleveland. And the Cavaliers pushing it up now. Okoro with it. Guarded now by Sexton. Utah's gone 4-6 from long range in the second quarter. Solid shooting
in the first half.
Huff can't hit.
Surprising he didn't bury that, but hey, it happens sometimes.
This one for three. And Colin Sexton with the three. Sexton's got eight.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five baskets are from three-point range.
Inside, here's Mobley. Tried to fade back in there, but it's off the mark. And so, Sexton will bring it up for the Jazz.
Jordan Clarkson.
Only giving up 2 points this quarter.
And there's the patience you want to see from Sexton. Eyes up and finds the open door.
And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Here's Garland. It's not going to go for him. The Jazz go the other way with it. From deep 3-point range, Mobley with the rebound. Mobley's got 4 rebounds now tonight. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
One area, Isaac Okoro has shown lots of growth, Richard, is in his defense.
Yeah, he's been trying to attack these players. You've got to find ways to get on the floor, and defense is one of them. It's something you can tell he's worked on, but there's just something about his natural ability and the way he's leaned into it.
And Cleveland making a change here. Lopez is checked in, and Utah also making a switch. Michael Conley, he's checked in for Jordan Clarkson. Here's Vanderbilt trying to get open as well. And there's another one for the Jazz.
How frustrating for the defense. If you get the stop, but then fail to block out.
And you can see them just barely after giving up that score. And they know that they can't dig themselves out of this hole if they're allowing second chance points.
Well, Cleveland shooting 38% from the field. A pretty weak showing for them. Okoro passes to Mobley, and he makes good play.
Off aggressive coverage. Mobley already looking like a vet out there.
Bounce pass Conley. Sexton for three. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Mobley's got his fifth rebound in this one.
He's been off. Still, they're off, so not all is and they repeatedly booked inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Sexton on the wing. A putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
He's so strong when he goes to work on the glass. One opening is all he'll need to finish the play, even if it's just a tip-in.
Sinks the triple.
A creative score. Mitchell uses that versatility and shot-making ability to keep the defenders guessing.
Jordan Clarkson getting it done for the Utah Jazz. A grand total of 28 points for him in the game now. They have no answer for him defensively. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Kevin. How do you guys get back in this game after the first half?
Thanks, Josh. I mean, we're getting good ones. We're just, I don't know what it is. We had a day off. City got legs under us in the second half. Come out, go on a big run like we usually do. We'll be fine.
We'll see how it goes. Thanks a lot, Kevin. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit. And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back to 2K Sports, everybody. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Let's talk about that first half. Jordan Clarkson was on fire in the first half. He ended up with 28 points, 2 steals, and 1 block. And last game, he could never really get going. Maybe that lit a fire under him tonight. And, Kenny, what you see out there from the Jazz?
The work they put in on the draft, really an all-hands-on-deck attack. Give them credit for being the more aggressive team. Rebounding is one of the stats that sometimes gets overlooked, but not tonight.
Shaq, how do you think Cleveland played?
It's their defense has put them in this spot. Giving up easy looks all over the place. Like they don't have even a game plan in place. Check out the field goal percentage that they've allowed. Well, that's not going to cut it. I don't even want to talk about it anymore.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks. Thanks goodbye, for folks. Joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
Trying to protect their lead.
You gotta like what Jordan Clarkson has done in this game.
No problems fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
And you love that mindset he has going at the rim. He hasn't settled for anything, and he's been the aggressor all game long.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. The defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Garland is out there with Mitchell, and it's Stevens in at the three spot. And that's the group for J.B. Bickerstaff as we begin the second half. And then Allen stands
it in.
G.A., it wasn't long ago that the Cavs were an afterthought in the NBA.
Well, not anymore. I mean, Cleveland has a tremendous young roster. They play some of the toughest D in the NBA. And they're only going to get better in the years to come.
Garland, the pass to Mitchell. Lined up there for Allen. The shot will not fall.
But the edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
Wasted no time on that one. Markkanen's got his first 3 points of the game.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Down low. And it's Allen with the jam.
Making up for it with some serious hops.
Here's Sexton. Allen with the rebound.
Now you can't look at the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
Yeah, it's a great look for him. One they'll try and manufacture again. Those are the shots you want him to take.
Sexton with the bounce pass. Conley for three. The basket good off the assist from Sexton. Sexton's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Pass to Stevens. Right over the net and snapped
to Dunn. Let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not cannot remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. And one more look at that fantastic Mobile One drop.
That's an incredible move by him on what's been an impressive night all around.
And home court advantage can give teams a huge lift. Greg, how different is it playing in front of the hometown bench?
It's huge. I mean, they give you energy. You don't want to let them down, so you tend to dig a little deeper when you're playing at home.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Jetty Osman, he's checked in for Moten. And Chris Roberts, the Garden. Switcher also for Utah. Archie's checked in.
This is how dominant Allen can be. If you continue to feed him, he will reward you.
Took him no time at all on that one. Conley's got two now from beyond the arc in the third for the Jazz. LeVert the pass to Stevens. Looking for Allen, he gets it there. Puts it up from 12. He can't get that one. And Utah the other way now. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Detroit, where they'll face the Pistons. That'll be the last game of their very short three-game road tour. Throws it from outside. He's got nine.
And that's back-to-back threes. The knee just seems to be slacking off a little bit. And for years, Mike Conley had an interesting title. The best player to ever make an All-Star game.
His shot has been on point from the opening tip. He's pretty much kept them in the game.
That bucket in no time at all. Markkanen's got six in the quarter.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
In the modern NBA, you have to hit threes to win games, and they've made that adjustment since the break.
Good shot by Mitchell, no good. For Mike Conley, year 13 was lucky for him, going to that first All-Star game.
And that was the longest wait ever to become an All-Star. Conley, 33 at the time of that first selection, just shows you the work ethic of Mike is always trying to improve.
This man is on fire. His team is winning, and it doesn't get better than that.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Mike's checked in. Then for the Jazz. Vanderbilt comes in for Kelly Olynyk. And Talen Horton-Tucker subbed in for Lauri Markkanen. To the paint. Here's Allen. And smacked up by Allen.
With the ball in his hands, Mitchell attracts attention and breaks down the defense. With the pass.
Here's Clarkson. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
And really the story of this second half, one team getting the shots they want, the other not so much.
And start with their defense. They've been intense on that end, and they can actually help their offense as well.
Pass to LeVert. Down low. Love. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist.
They are just killing them on the interior.
And it's Conley with the ball for the Utah Jazz. Here's Horton-Tucker, and again, it's the Jazz from deep.
And those aren't the type of three-point opportunities that you can allow in the NBA.
Here's Mitchell. It's deflected.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
Clarkson for three, and the Jazz on another three.
3 points. The man is a microwave. This team loves Clarkson's take-charge attitude when it comes to scoring.
Pass to Osman. Jacks up a three. Cleveland gets it back.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
And again, it's the Jazz from deep.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
They get it again. Love. Offensive struggles continue, missing again. And so it's the Utah Jazz holding an unbelievable lead as the quarter ramps up. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. We've got more in store for you right after this. Shooting well, they're at 45. 45%. Taking a look at the Jazz, you've got Conley, and it's Alexander Walker hitting the two-guard. And he comes up with the deuce. Lopez has got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the Cavs. That was a second look at our Mobile One Drive. Amazing control on display.
And I just love his competitiveness he's showing there. Team might be down, but a drive like that could spark them.
Yes, once again, it remains perfect. Six attempts and six hits.
Well, he's been doing it all night. Why not go back to it?
Yeah, just keep feeding him. That guy is a man on a mission. And the defense, well, they don't have much of an answer.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play. Then the emphatic stuff.
Yeah, once he jumps it away.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Conley. That is his first foul of the game.
The Jazz
making a switch. Beasley's checked in. And that kind of stifling effort on defense needs another look.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
Beasley with the steal. Fires for three. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Beasley's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for the Utah Jazz. The pass to Stevens. Shot to stop the run. Here's Osman. And there's the bucket. Getting it done.
That's a blue-collar bucket right there. Grown man basket. Put it in the work. Got a second chance to score.
Utah's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. For three, Beasley. And Utah on another three.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Let's it go from 11. Second shot opportunity. And it's Osman missing. Jazz have gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Out of bounds. Cleveland takes possession. Mobley is checked in for Jenny Osman. Going to switch here also for Utah. As Ibuka is checked in. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. Okoro kicks to Neto. That one goes. Neto's got his first points of the night.
No issues on that one. Good work all around.
Horton Tucker, the pass to Beasley. And again, it's the Jazz from Beasley.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
I think when you've got it going from three-point range, you've got to keep it going. It's a good way to kind of pile up the points quickly.
It's blocked, and that'll be Cleveland as it goes out of bounds. Cavaliers retain possession.
Substitution.
Garland, he's checked in for Cleveland. Here's Neto, and it's in there. Neto's got 4 points in the quarter.
He sets his man up there, runs it right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
And that one's good by Gay.
And Gay has great length down on the block there. Fantastic at just jumping on opportunities to score when he's down low.
Garland got that bucket.
It's so easy on offense. Like, who takes pleasure in torturing defenses? He does.
2 minutes.
So it's Mobley now who brings it up for the Cleveland Cavaliers. For three, Asabuki. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Garland left side. And there's Mobley, and that's it. That's by Garland.
A quality pass setting up a quality shot. It's just textbook basketball.
Beasley, the best to Asabuki. Back to Beasley. The tray bangs home the trifecta. Beasley's got 12 points here in the second half.
He's just stretching them out. The defense has got to do a better job of staying attached to him.
And the lack of defensive pressure on shots like that is a big reason they're down by double digits.
Utah has gone 4-6 from beyond the arc in the fourth quarter so far.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Jazz.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. And on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And in terms of the season, right, this is going to be their 18th win overall.
And with the win approaching, they'll take the first game here of two that they'll play against this team. Nice to get that first one out of the way and set the tone.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Jordan Clarkson.
He did a great job following his team's game plan and not rushing anything on offense, which allowed him to catch fire.
And it's Utah's ball. Shoots from 14, he gets that one.
And credit the whole team. It was a focused, concerted effort to put this one away.
And it felt like they just flipped the switch to go on that run and see the goal. Saving their best basketball for the end. Always smart.
4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Garland cans the 12-footer.
That's absolutely a shot that Garland has in his back pocket just for moments like this.
From deep, Abaji can't get it to go. Now Garland. And so it's Utah easily grabbing the win.
That's the
to come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says that they know an awful lot about this team.
I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Jordan. Congrats on the win. Huge night offensively. What does it feel like to ride that wave?
It feels good. My teammates, man, they were fine to me. He was screening, he was playing well, moving the ball like how he's supposed to do and what we preach. We just did a great job. Keeping guys in front of him. Everybody just pitched in, and another great team win.
You were a big part of that, man. Congrats. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for watching. So long, everyone.